So, it seems like anytime there's a new item, new couple together, everyone wants to hear the story of how they met. So,
on our long road trip out here to North Carolina the other day, we talked about it and decided...
We ironed out the details,
yes.
how it actually went down.
Yeah, so we decided that we would put on Facebook. That way you guys don't ever wonder and there's no rumors going around. So pretty much we just would like to set the record straight.
Yeah, here it is.
Yeah.
Ryan and Caroline.
The story.
So I was working in a clinic while I was in college, and it was a psychiatric clinic. And a lot of different patients come in. You know, with all kinds of weird problems. You know, seeing stuff, and schizophrenia, and all kinds of stuff like that. I mean, this one patient came in here. I've never seen a more messed up individual in my entire life. She had schizophrenia and dementia and delusions of grandeur. She thought that she was a teacup. But I convinced her that she was Caroline. I don't really know your real name.
So it's hard. No, so actually how I met Ryan was a couple years ago when I started training. Ryan, he doesn't look like it, but Ryan used to be about 400 pounds. And yeah.
So... a couple of years ago, my long-time friends were doing this. I had kind of a dark spell, I guess you could say, where I kind of, got mixed up with the wrong crowd, kind of got into some bad stuff. One night, I ended up calling a escort service. And they sent me. Discount package.
Ouch. Like how long in my eye. It burns.
I'm sorry.
I'm just gonna leave no pressure.
So, Ryan and I met him, it's been like 3 or 4 years ago now.
Yeah.
I went out to a bar with some friends, and at the time, you say you always need to know your friends. Well, it's a true story. I didn't realize that one of them liked, well, the bar that we went to was like for cross-dressing. Yes, and Ryan, he was the prettiest girl up there.
I was the prettiest princess.
He was the pretty, pretty princess.
Caroline's what you call a cholo. I don't even know what that means. What is cholo?
It's like a Mexican. Ryan used to be an ice skater.
So, I like to eat healthy. So I get a lot of organic produce and stuff like that. And there's a kind of a community farm. And they take in a lot of what I would call misguided views, and if you're brainwashed in this whole green environmental stuff. So they go live on these sustainable community farms and they grow their own food and all that. Well, I was looking for some grass fed butter and went there and we should do more for the cows. But a dreadlocked and hairy armpitted.
I didn't wear deodorant.
Right, you didn't shake your leg, did you?
That's not important right now. Ryan used to come, used to be involved with an alternate lifestyle. the kind where, you still kind of believe it. He believed that, everybody was born free, and in being free, he didn't believe in wearing clothes. And so he He was on a nudist colony for quite some time. And made a lot of really close friends.
What were you doing there when you... You ready for the real story? Caroline was a hooker.
That is... You told that like 3 times.
It's my favorite.
As a stripper. So, how I met Ryan. Samantha and I were going to the mall, like we really normally do. Well, back when I was like 18, 19, all the time. Ryan worked at the, what do you call it? The MAC counter. He was really good at putting makeup on. And men.
You can use a touch-up. thank you. So, back when we had a band, back in high school, we weren't that big a deal. So it's not like we had a huge following. It was actually high school. But we did have one groupie who was very persistent. Very persistent.
Actually, I met Ryan. My sister got married a couple years ago, and we needed our dresses hemmed, and he's a good seamstress. It's not funny.
Seamstress.
So, okay, no, this is a true story. I got an apartment like a year ago, and it was kind of in the South Oklahoma City, which is known for, you know, crazy stuff going on. The first few months there were no problem at all. And then I started to notice, like, this exterior that would follow me as I went home. And it wasn't too long after that that I started noticing, like, I would close my blind at night, and there would be, like, this on my head in front, and then, like, disappear. And, yeah. Turns out, told me.
I like drugs.
So,
wait. It's a burp, but now I'm laughing.
The last story. So, it took us a couple days to decide, but
we finally figured it out. Okay, but the real story.
Yeah, real time.
7.5 years ago-ish, I met Caroline while I was playing the drums for a church youth group, and we played at her church, and her parents were the youth pastors at the time. So, them being the youth pastors, us being the visiting youth band, we hung out with him a couple times, but that's when I met her. That's not really when I got to know her, though.
Yeah, our friendship kind of started when I left for BASIC. We had a going away party, and their whole band came to my going away party at church, and I was asking everybody to write me, and Ryan decided that he would start
actually
writing.
Do that.
It was kind of a surprise because we didn't really know each other that well, so all of his letters were really entertaining. And
he was like one stranger writing to
another. But it was really sweet, and that's kind of when we started talking. And after I got home, we kind of picked up from there. Found out that we both were really passionate about the same stuff, so developed a really tight friendship.
Yeah, and then shortly after developing that friendship, I left for college, and then went further away from college, so I was gone for a year and a half, and then left for BASIC and AIT, and
I left for various TDYs all over the country. So.
Seemed like every time I would come home, she would leave to go somewhere crazy in the world.
So the majority of our friendship has been kind of together and then apart and together and apart, but a lot
sporadic.
Has been.
So, 2 months ago we started officially dating, and I kind of decided that 2 months is a really long time to just date your best friend.
So, I am extremely excited to be meeting my best friend, because no matter where we go, and no matter how far apart we are, for however long, we'll be there. When I get home, we'll be there. That's the story.